First, I give honor to our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ. Greetings, Star of a Hope Church family, and to all that who may join in with us on this morning. To our First Lady, my wife, Sister Lisa McKoy. This morning, I would like for us to take a moment to pause here for a moment of silence for the 100,000 plus people who have lost lives due to this global pandemic. And also, let us be in prayer on behalf of the Albright family down in the state of Georgia. Also, the Floyd family up in the state of Minnesota. This nation stands in the need of prayer. Let us bow our heads for a moment of silence. Amen. As we continue to go through this global pandemic, we do ask that we continue to check on one another, continue to communicate one with the other throughout our church family and beyond, especially identifying our elderly as we still fight this virus. We do ask everyone to please continue to adhere to all the guidelines that have been set before us, even though they are laxing in what we need to do. We need to continue to wear our masks, continue to wash our hands frequently, continue to social distance, and to wear our gloves when necessary. Amen. After a song, we will be back before you for our prayer.
Down through the years, the Lord's been good to me. Down through the years, the Lord's been good to me. I'm trying to tell you, down through the years, the Lord's been tell you that the Lord's
been good.
I know the
Lord's been good.
I said the
Lord's been good.
Just think about it. The
Lord's been good.
Coming down 85,
the Lord's been good.
285 and I-20, the
Lord's.
Let us pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, it's again we call on your holy and your precious name. God, we just ask you right now to just touch us with your precious finger of love. Lord, we ask you to continue to bless this country, bless this world, God, that is going through. You said in your word that you would never leave us nor forsake us. And Lord, we believe in thee. Lord, we ask you to touch all those that are sick, all those that are hospital bound, prison bound. Oh Lord, we just ask you to touch them with your precious finger of love. Lord, just have your way on today. Touch all bereaved families wherever they may be. And Lord, we ask you to continue to touch those who have lost loved ones through carelessness. Touch them right now in the precious name of Jesus. Oh Lord, continue to touch this church family. Oh God, continue to touch them one by one, and then touch us all together in one band of Christian love. Lord, just continue to have your way. And God, we'll continue to give you the praise, the honor, and the glory that is due. We ask this in the name of the Father, the Son, and the blessed Holy Ghost. We count it done in Jesus' name. Amen. At this time, we'll prepare for our scripture coming from Paul McKoy, Our Welcome by Naisha Willie. And following that, we will have a selection, and I will be back before you with a word on today. Amen.
Good morning. I will be coming from Genesis 22, verses 1 through 7. And it came to pass after these things that God did tempt Abraham, and said unto him, Abraham, and he said, Behold, here I am. And he said, Take not thy son, thy only son Isaac, whom thou lovest, and get thee into the land of Moriah, and offer him therefore a burnt offering upon one of the mountains which I will tell thee of. And Abraham rose up early in the morning, and saddled his ass, and took two of his young men with him, and Isaac his son, and clave the wood for the burnt offering, and rose up and went into the place of which God had told him. Then on the third day, Abraham lifted up his eyes and saw the place afar off. And Abraham said unto his young men, Abide ye with the ass, and I the lad will go yonder and worship and come again to you. And Abraham took the wood of burnt offering and laid it upon Isaac his son. And he took the fire in his hand and a knife, and they went both of them together. And Isaac spake unto Abraham his father, and said, My father. And he said, Here I am, my son. And he said, Behold the fire and the wood, but where is the lamb for a burnt offering? I have just read Genesis verses 1 through 7. May God add a blessing to the reading of his word.
Good morning, Star of Hope Church family. On the behalf of our pastor, Bishop Wayne McKoy Sr., and our First Lady, Alicia McKoy, Associate Elder Holmes, and Sister Teresa Holmes, we would like to welcome you to our church service today. If you are not part of the church family, you are still welcome.
He knows my name. She knows my name. And oh, how he walks with me. So how he talks with me, yeah, and oh how he tells me that I am his own,
thank those that have come forth for our scripture and our welcome. Our scripture has already been read, Genesis, the 22nd chapter, verses 1 through 7. Genesis, the 22nd chapter, verses 1 through 7. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we just want to say thank you for this day. Lord, we ask that you decrease me. Let your words come through these old lips of clay, that it might be a word for our people on today. In Jesus' name, we do declare, amen. A couple of weeks ago, I preached from the subject, A Test of Your Faith. And this morning, by way of subject, coming from this, the 22nd chapter of Genesis, when our faith is tested. When our faith is tested. Tests, trials, worries, disappointment, and frustrations are all a part of every human life. We read in the scriptures that Abraham was tested. He was tested by God. He was tested in order to bring out the good that was in Abraham. And he also was tested in order that he might have a great testimony of those around him. And so we are also tested in many different ways. This morning I want to talk about three of those ways. Number one, we are tested by Satan. Number two, we are tested by men. And finally, number three, we are tested by God. When Satan puts men to the test, he does so in order to bring out the evil in us. His motive is to hurt, harm, and destroy. It is interesting to note that our Lord was tempted and was tested, and he was victorious over those temptations that were designed to destroy him and to wreck God's redemption plan. Satan uses the same methods today that he used in tempting Jesus. First, he promised him plenty. So he does with so many men and women today. He promises us everything. Men still desire to have plenty of things of this world. And the devil is still promising the moon and the stars if we would just follow him. He promises us plenty. And secondly, he promises us popularity. If we would just follow him and those who seek fame and fortune, they find themselves in the grips of Satan. And then finally, he promises us great success. Satan was trying to tell Jesus that it was unnecessary for him to suffer the ordeal of the cross in order to cause the kingdoms of this world to become the kingdom of God. But remember this. When Satan puts us through a trial or puts us through a test, it is always to hurt, harm, or destroy. Yes, men are still being tested by Satan. Secondly, men are tested by men. Men will test our friendship. Men will test our humility. Men will test our loyalty. They even will test our patience. At times, they try to test our integrity. But we are endowed with the capacity to make judgments and distinguish between the things that differ. Men will come and test our leadership potential. some for the good or some for the bad. But men will test men. I stand today to let you know that we all will be tested at some time. And finally, men are tested by God. But God needs men and women upon whom he can depend. God needs men and women in whom he can trust. I trust with the rich gift of the Spirit for the good of others. The tests from God are revealed. The purpose behind these tests are never revealed immediately. The tests that come from God are designed by his love for us. These tests are motivated by his love for us. A test that comes from God is a vote of divine confidence in us. The tests that come from God are always motivated by his love for us. And as he is seeking to lift us and to enlarge us for his glory. The tests that come from God are never beyond our power to conquer with divine help. He always promises his presence with us and his power to assist us if we will but trust him and be faithful unto him. The tests that come from God enable us to live more abundantly and to serve more effectively. Abraham became a greater man because he was faithful unto God. And when God put him to the test, God is faithful and dependable. God is gracious and he's merciful. And every test is designed to bring out the good in us. And I'm reminded of the story here in Genesis, the 22nd chapter, in verses 1 through 7. Here we had a man that had true faith in a true and a living God. And one day God put a test to Abraham. And he had Abraham to take his only son by the name of Isaac, had him take him up into a mountain where there was to be a sacrifice. But when they got to the site, Isaac asked him and said, now where is, we see the wood and we see the fire, but where is the sacrifice? I stopped by to let you know this morning, when we go through a test and we got our hands in the winding chain and we've got ourselves in order to serve a true and a living God. Some of you are going through some tests right now, but I stopped by this morning to let you know, if you just continue to trust in our Lord, if you continue to obey the Lord and what he has told us to do, you too can find a ram in the bush. I don't know about you, but I've been tested. But I found out that because I serve a God that is faithful, he brought me out every situation that I could not bring myself out. You know, this morning, you are in a test right now because this pandemic has tested our very being. It has tested the minds of some. It has tested the mental state of some. It has tested the financial status of some. But what I want all of you to know, there is an avenue of escape. And his name is Jesus. And if you're going through a test this morning, I want you to turn it over to our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ. He never tests us just because he gives each and every one of us an appropriate test. And that will bring us closer to him. Abraham was tested. The test that he put Abraham through, many men could not have withstood the test. Knowing that you are taking your only son to be sacrificed unto the Lord. When our faith is tested, we got to know in whom we trust. We have to know in whom we serve, and his name is Jesus. I believe that there is someone that may be listening on today that is going through, and I want to point you to a man named Jesus. And whatever he says he will do it for you. The doors of the church are open. And he's asking you now to come. It doesn't matter where you are. You're in the right place to give your life to Christ. And if that's you, and I want you to find you a church home that you may have a covering. We welcome you here to Star of Hope, Original Free Will Baptist Church. But if not, find a church near you. Let us pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we just want to say thank you. We thank you for your many blessings. God, we thank you for what you've already done. We thank you for what you're doing right now and for what you're yet to do. Lord, we just ask you to have your way in our lives. And we know now that when we come through our trials and when we come through our tests, you're standing there with your arms wide open. Lord, we thank you and we praise you. We give you the honor and all the glory. In the name of the Father, the Son, the blessed Holy Ghost, we count it done in Jesus' name. Amen. We thank God for you, all of you that have listened upon us on this morning. We pray something was said that would help you along your journey in this life that we live. Also, as we prepare for our benediction, we do ask that you continue to keep our sick and our shut-in in our prayers. Amen. We have several that have given praise reports on this week. Sister Betty Boykins and Sister DeVore Murchison. And certainly our very own dear Teresa Holmes is back at home. So we certainly thank God for the praying saints. And until again next Sunday, may the sweet communion of his Holy Spirit rest, rule, and abide with us henceforth and forever. Let us all say amen, amen, and amen. God bless you, and may heaven smile upon you, is our prayer.